We'll look at having a sprite fall from the top of the screen, so we can use it in a game where you have to click on the sprite before it hits the bottom. Here, I'll work on a script for my apple. When the green flag is clicked, I want it to go to a random spot on the top, wait for a bit, and then fall down. I'll start by hiding the sprite. Then I'll wait 0 to 3 seconds. To wait 0 to 3 seconds, I need to use a random block. Then I want to move to a random spot on the top of the screen. At the top I'll go to is 194. And I want to pick an x value between negative 220 and positive 220. Once I do that, I'll show the sprite. Let's see if this works so far. So after a random amount of time, an apple should appear at the top. There it is. Now I want to keep the apple moving down until it gets to the bottom of the screen. I can go to Control, and I'll say Repeat Until. And I want to repeat until the Y position of this apple is at the bottom. So I'll say, once the Y position is less than negative 190, so that'll be right at the bottom, what I want to do is I want to change Y by negative 5. So that'll move the character down. Let's try the script now. It's always a good idea to build scripts a little bit at a time and keep testing it as you go. So the apple should appear and then fall down. Once it gets to the bottom, where you can see the Y value is negative 191, I stop changing Y by negative 5. Now what I want to do is if you click on the apple, it should disappear. To do that, I'll use an if block. I want to see if the mouse is down and you're touching the fruit selector. The fruit selector is my cursor. So I want both of those to be true, so I need to use an and block. So I can say if the mouse down and touching fruit selector, then what do I want to do? I've made a variable score, and I want to change the score by 1. I also want to hide my character. Let's click the green flag so the cursor follows my mouse and see if this works like we expect. So the apple appears, and then when I click on it, it disappears. Looks good. I could have this same apple keep falling just by putting a repeat loop around this. I could even say forever, do all of those steps. Now let's see what happens. I got that one. Now if I don't catch the apple, he'll go to the bottom and disappear. Then he'll wait and reappear. And look how my score changes once I click on one of the apples. 3 points. If I want multiple things to fall from the sky, I could duplicate this sprite. But then, if I have a bug, I'll need to make the changes in all the duplicated sprites. There's a better way to do this, which is using clone, which you can learn about in another video.